Hello everyone, my name is Obato Kolu Asheo, popularly known as Rito Babs, and this is Money Matters Africa. Okay, I quickly want to give a response to the question a guy asked me from the podcast that we released last week, you know, from the radiopublic.com. Okay, he asked me that, Rito Babs, how can I become a real estate agent in Nigeria? And I wanted to answer him, but based on the time, we don't have enough time on the show. So I'm like, I'm going to do a YouTube video for him to just start. And once he's watching this video now, I believe he's going to get the tips we are going to provide for him. So of course, to become a successful real estate agent in Nigeria, you need to look at some factors before you could start. Okay, so there are countless of real estate agents in Nigeria that your ability to persuade your clients and your negotiation skills may not be enough. So there are things you should know in order to stand out in this field. Okay, now, so in relating to real estate investors like sellers and buyers, the following will help you, you know, to guide you as a real estate agent. And how do you become a real estate agent in Nigeria, as I speak now, in Lagos, in Ogun State, in Oyo State, in Kaduna, in mention the states in Nigeria for you to become successful real estate agent and not ordinary a real estate agent. These are the things you need to do. Number one, you need to know your objectives. Knowing your objectives. And how do you know your objectives? Why do you want to become a real estate agent is the question you should ask yourself. I remember when I started my real estate business, the journey so far, I was a student when I started. I used to be with my mentor then, and my mentor will be negotiating with people on phone. Oh, madam, okay, how are you doing today? That land at Lekki is going for 7 million naira, but if you want us to help you build the you know, the mansion and do everything, it's going to cost you 270 million naira. And I moved by the money, the amount of the money he used to call. I'm like, wow, if this man could be calling these millions of naira, this amount of money, of course I'm successful. And you know this popular saying that a foolish man among 7 millionaires will eventually become a millionaire. So, and the otherwise, the vice versa is a millionaire among 7 foolish or a poor man will eventually become a poor. So that thing turns my head. That was the objective that drive me at the initial stage. And I won't say, let me advise you now that I don't want you to make money to be the objective of you going into real estate business or becoming an agent. So now your objective should be answered honestly. What is that particular thing that is driving you to want to go into real estate business, and why do you think you are going to succeed? So that should be your objective. You need to know it, answer the question honestly, and this will determine if the career is best for you. It is beyond finding and purchasing properties, and you should have interest in houses and the architectural details too, like you seeing buildings and construction, how it looks like. You need to do what? You need to have passion for it. The number two thing I will talk about is get trained. You may want to sign up with established real estate companies for training. So in that way, you will learn in structured environment along with other real estate agents they will be recruiting. So you can also be recruited by that company as their agents. As time goes on, you know, they see that you are responding to their learning, to the tutorial they are giving you. So, but if you want to become an independent agent, you can still get training organized by those companies or those real estate schools. And some of these trainings are available in Lagos, they're available in Ogun State, they're available in Abuja. Though I won't mention the name of the schools because I'm not doing advert for any school. Of course, if you want to do a one-on-one real estate masterclass with me, my WhatsApp number is down here. My Gmail or my email address is there, so you can always contact me and I will do a one-on-one class with you on how you could go about your real estate and becoming a certified real estate agent. So this will improve you, you know, going to that school and learning the basics will improve your communication skills, and you will learn how to build a strong network with brokers, with sellers, with buyers and real estate companies like that. So you have more information on things happening in the real estate world, in the real estate sectors. The number three things I will talk about is you need to learn the habit of responding promptly to leads. Like, it makes you more reliable when you respond to leads early, be it via phone calls, via emails, text messages, or social media. This will also make you, you know, to be open for more opportunities when you are contacted as fast as possible and you reply them. Like they call you, hello, Rita Babs. Actually, I saw your contact on the advert you did on this, and I saw the property at Victoria Island. How can I just? You don't want to neglect the call that, oh, this is my hot hour. This is 11 o'clock, 11 p.m. in the night. I can't pick up this call. I will reply to them tomorrow morning. The person might desperately be in need for the property, and you don't have any choice than to respond, to reply to that person. I'm telling you, you don't have any choice to reply. In Nigeria, you don't have closing time in doing business. You don't have closing time. 2 a.m., somebody can call you that, oh, I need to get this done. I need to get this done. I need you to counsel me on how this particular property should go. I need to, you know, to know many things. You don't have any, I'm telling you, in other businesses, this applies to. Maybe you think somebody's going to call you now and you are going to neglect the call and you reply them tomorrow. You want to do officiate like the Western people would do. You don't have closing time in Nigeria, so you need to respond promptly to leads if you want to be successful in doing real estate business. So another thing I will talk about is the technology. In this age of remarkable technological advancements, you won't be doing yourself any good, excuse me, by not leveraging on the available tools. So there are many things you can do. You can make YouTube videos as I'm doing now. So sometimes you have to pay for advertisements. You need to have active social media accounts. I have Instagram account. I have Twitter account. My Facebook is active. Just do all you can to put yourself out there. Create ads that are targeted towards people that need your services. So these things tells your clients you can handle their job and you can take them seriously. So it will show your exposure. It will show how available are you, you know, in the world to your clients. So another thing is move. You need to move around, see places, visit properties, and take note of their unique selling points. Is it their location? Is it the beauty? Is it the structure of the building? You know, you should be able to move and speak to people. Don't just stay bundukushiously. You won't see that in the dictionary. So my mentor used to say that you shouldn't be stagnant and be believing that, okay, everything you get online is what you will use to market. Of course, this is not an Airbnb stuff. You get? So another point I will make mention of is you staying informed. You should always know what is happening in your neighborhood. It is not enough to know just the names of the streets. You should also have a broad knowledge of the best schools around, the best restaurants, the location of hospitals, you know, the kind of people who live there, the best places to shop. Your clients will have a lot of questions to ask you based on those information you have, the landmark that is near to the property you want to sell to them, and lots more. So you need to be gallant in getting information, in sourcing information. I will talk also about being reliable. Being reliable consists of you listening to your clients and find the properties they want. They will tell you, this is the property I want. Don't just come to them and market them that, oh, I have property at Lekki, I have property at Magodo. Okay, don't you think you should go for this one? No. Don't suggest to them. Listen to them, hear them. Rita Babs, this is where I want my property to be located. I want a property that is not more than 15 million naira in Lagos. So you should be able to listen to them, know what they want, notwithstanding the amount it will cost them. So knowing what they can afford, should get. So once you listen to them and you're able to give a suggestion to what they have, at the initial stage, you might not have the property at that location that they requested for. But as an agent, you need to go extra mile to make it available for them. Of course, you will put your own commissions to the service you are rendering. The 5% commission is there. Remember, So we'll be reliable to them. You get it? So I will talk about another point, which is you need to pay attention to your client. This is almost related to being reliable. So in advising your clients, when you think they're about to make a wrong decision, you should be polite about it. Be polite about it. Never be rude, no matter what. Whether they have money and you see that this person is desperate to get this property, like, you know, now. No, listen to them, have a great conversation to them, calm them down. It is wrong to interrupt. You get it? So I would also like to talk about being professional. There is no business in the world now that any customer or anybody want to come and meet you. They see that you lack that competence and you're not professional, they will be scared to relay with you. You get it? So you need to be professional. You need to have a business card so you can easily give it to potential clients. So if you are an independent agent, you should also have an office to work and meet with clients. So it's all part of branding, and it will help you with loans seriously. So if you're taking in and getting referrals from people, so it will make you more professional. So in doing that, of course, if you are starting out as somebody who don't have much, like from zero balance now, and you want to grow your you know, success in real estate business, you can actually start, you know, from that zero. This thing, you don't need an office. Just sign up with the real estate companies in your state, in Nigeria, in Lagos State, in Ogun State, in Abuja. You know, sign up with them, and as a starter realtor. Of course, I'll mention some real estate companies that does that. I'm with Landway Investments. I'm with Novaricoms and Property. I'm with Sule.com, which is Nigerian property. You can search my name on Google. I'm there. Babatope Oluwase on Realtor Babs. You'll see me all over. You get it. So now, this is it. If you don't have an office, just try to be on social media. Let the social media be your office. And whenever you're going to close a deal, maybe you're running an avatar on those social media, you can always go back to the real estate companies. You get it. So by so doing, you'll be very fine. I'll talk about another point, which is care. People know when a person truly cares about them. That is just the basic truth. The relationship you have with your clients should be professional, like I said earlier on. So both you showing care when listening to them, you trying to be professional, and all those things matters. So once you are trying to engage them in discussion, and they see that you don't even care about them, you are just trying to market them and, you know, just want to collect the money in their hand, they will know. I'm telling you, they will know. I've related with a customer like that, and, you know, because I need some certain amount of money urgently, then due to some financial challenges I went through. Of course, there is nobody above going through that financial challenges. So then I was so curious to just sell the property with me and just make money and close the deal very fast. And the client sees it in me that this guy does not even care. It's just about selling the distance out and just to get the money and his own. So eventually the man did not let her buy. But as time goes on, I try to engage him in discussion to know the reason why he doesn't buy from me. And he said to me, "Realtor Babs, this is what happened. This is what happened. I see that you don't give me much attention. You don't care about me. You just want to do this and that." And I said, "Wow, sincerely, that was what happened. And I promise you that won't happen again." And of course, the man is my customer now. He bought a property from us and he's doing fine. So you need to show care to them. Try to show in little things a way that you are concerned about their well-being. You know, a client should not just tell you they are sick and you won't at least make a phone call to them or send a message to them. Of course, we don't pray that to happen to our clients. So you need to show care to them. So once the caring aspect is there, you are always what? Good to go. So those are the basic things you need to have, the skills you need to train yourself. As it easy as it is, as I made mention of it, you'll be thinking, "Oh, is that all I need to do to..." If you don't follow that process duly, you might end up having problem becoming a real estate agent. Of course, the last thing I want to talk about is you becoming a certified real estate agent, real realtor, becoming a certified sales consultant, and so you can, as the time goes by, once you are done with your class with the real estate companies, you can suggest to them that, are they going to give you a license to become a sales consultant, to become a realtor with them, you know, so for customers, for you to show your customers that I'm certified, you can always trust in me, this is it, I'm working with Landway, I'm working with Novarec Homes and Properties, I'm working with all these things. Of course, you can tell them and they will always give you, and if at all they don't give you and you want to become an individual, you know, real estate agent, you can go through the state government policy and their process to become a certified real estate. So for Lagos State, you need to register with LASRETRAD. LASRETRAD is spelled LASRETRAD.com. So you need to visit that website. I'm going to drop the link below. Visit the site, check, you know, all about, see how you can register with them, how you can be a licensed individual, and you're good to go. Once you have the government backup, you are very fine. Check it. So for Ogun State, you need to check. For Abuja, you need to check the state, Abuja Land State Bureau, and see what they have for you there. So I'm going to drop some link below, of course, so you know how to go about that. The certification aspect is the most basic and the most crucial part of what you need to get in becoming a successful real estate agent, real estate consultant, realtor, anything, anytime, any English you want to use for it, and you are good to go. So another one is lagospa.gov.ng. So it's going to show you the Lagos State Government Land Bureau. So for somebody watching me now, and like the guy that asked me the question, so I believe I've answered your question now very well. So I want you to kickstart something now, and I want you to share your testimony with me. Thank you very much. I still remain Babatope Oluwaseun, your realtor, and I'm saying bye-bye.